You know, when I compose music, I have visuals in my head, in my mind. There is a cinematographic kind of aspect on it. I can't describe it exactly, you know, what it is, but it's like opening up rooms and going to places and, you know, being at different places. That's what the music makes. So anytime I work with Lilleven, he's actually able to capture these things that I have in my mind anyway. And it's like opening landscapes. It's actually exactly the same. It's like I improvise with my sounds and my sound banks, sounds and parts of pieces that I have. And that's what Lilleven is doing as well. And it's really, it's like playing together. But instead of playing sounds, he plays pictures. And I think that's a great combination. It's also, you know, the way we perform it, we're both on stage, so it also feels like playing with someone. Well, I've been using it at a very early stage. I worked with different people, but sometimes it was really good, but sometimes it also turned out to be like a digital overkill. There was too much information from the sound and the visuals. And at that time, I actually abandoned visuals for a while. And I also came back playing the guitar live. So I thought at least I can, you know, give the audience some kind of performance, not only staring at the laptop, which I of course do. I'm still doing that, but I also play guitar. So there's two elements already for a listener to watch. And I came back then, after a while, I came back to work with John Rosencroft from the Touch label. He was doing visuals for me, very nice visuals. Lilleven, I enjoy working with him the most, maybe. And there was also an Italian friend of mine, Giuseppe La Spada, who was doing visuals for me a while, which were great as well. You know, music listeners can be very conservative with this. They want to see someone sweating on stage and making the big show and all that. Fair enough, it's okay, you know, but in the end, it's about the music, isn't it? The music has to be good. I mean, I don't know. I mean, sometimes you can watch people flipping out on stage and the music's shit. Yeah. You know? So, I don't know. I'm aware that it's still not a perfect solution that we have now with electronic music on a rock stage. But it's what the people want, you know. Yeah. I mean, in the early days, we've been trying to put that music in different rooms and different settings and all that, but it didn't really develop in any direction. In the end, they always wanted to have us back on a rock stage, so what can we do, you know? I think I did. I mean, you know, the guitar was my first instrument and my main instrument, and then I was at the same time always very interested in developing my sound with any kind of treatments, and the computer seemed to be the most convenient tool to work with. But I had to come back to the guitar because it's kind of an anchor, you know, it's kind of roots me, and it's, you know, where I'm coming from. So I'm still working on that right balance. I'm not there yet, but I'm getting closer. Oh, it's very different. When I do film soundtracks, it's, you know, you put your work in the service of something, in this case, in the service of a filmmaker. And depending on the project, it's, you try to make a sound design and try to compose the music in a certain direction. But with Lilleven, it's like playing jazz. It's like free improvisation, you know. I've always been in between everything. You know, I've been working with musicians from the new music scene, you know, new classical music scene, as well as free improvisers, as well as pop musicians and rock musicians. But in a way that never has been a problem for me. It was always very natural. And I consider myself being in between. And I can learn from any side, and I feel good being within things.